Hello students, welcome to class 10 physics class. Today we discuss sign convention for spherical lenses. As earlier we discussed the sign convention for spherical mirrors, this convention is same for both lens as and mirror. Okay, so let's again we studied this sign conventions. So, in last class or in last video, we discussed the image formation by concave and convex lens and their uses. I hope there is no problem. If you have any problem, please write in a comment box. Let's start the today's topic, sign convention for spherical lenses. In spherical mirror, the pole is considered as a origin. Here, the optical center is considered as a origin, and the principal axis for both cases is taken as a x-axis of the coordinate system, because this is a new Cartesian coordinate. The sign convention is based on the new Cartesian coordinate. So let's talk about the conventions. So first convention, we already know that always when we draw the ray diagram, always we draw the object left side of the lens and as well as for the mirror. Second number, all distances, when we measure the distance, object distance, image distance, any distance, always they are parallel to the principal axis and measured from the optical center of the lens, because it is considered as the origin. So whatever the distance we measure from origin to that point. Third number, all the distances measured to be to the right of the origin, that means if a lens is there, then behind the lens, that means right side, your right side, that is along x-axis, is taken as a positive. If left side is there, the distance measured in the left side of the origin, that is minus x-axis, are taken as a negative. Fourth number, distance measured perpendicular to the above the principal axis, that means along y-axis, if the object is above the principal axis, then it will be positive. The height or size, it will be positive. And if it will be below the principal axis, then it is negative. So when we solve the numerical, we understand it better, because when we find out the height or size of the image, if the image value comes in negative, that means image form below the principal axis. If the image value comes in positive, image value means size of the image or height of the image. So if it comes positive, that means it is along the positive y-axis, that means it placed or it formed above the principal axis. Clear? So these are the sign conventions. We know this sign convention because already we discussed in spherical mirrors. Okay. Next topic is lens formula, similar to the mirror formula. But difference is, in mirror formula, we use 1 by f equals to 1 by b plus 1 by u. But in case of a lens formula, we use 1 by f equals to 1 by v minus 1 by u. That's why in maximum book, it will be written as 1 by v first in plus, because the minus is their lens formula. So in mirror formula, we do not write 1 by u plus 1 by b. But meaning is same. Plus a plus b, b plus a, we get the same value because of this similarities. Similarities because 1 by f equals to 1 by b, 1 by u, but there is a positive sign, there is a negative sign. For lens maker, lens formula gives us the relationship between the focal length f, image distance v, and the object distance u. The difference is 1 by f equals to 1 by v minus 1 by u. But in case of a mirror formula, 1 by v plus 1 by u. And this formula is valid in all situations for any spherical lenses. Either it will be convex lens or concave lens, it will same for both lenses. Next, magnification. Magnification, we know that it is a ratio of the size of an image or the height of an image to the height of an object. So here, height of an image is denoted by h dash, and h is the height of an object. So m equals to magnification is denoted by m. We know this because we already studied in case of a spherical mirror. M equals to h dash by h. Now magnification, similar to the spherical mirror, magnification also related to object distance and image distance. So here also for lens, for this spherical lenses, the magnification also related to image distance and object distance. But the difference is, in case of a spherical mirror, m equals to we have minus v by u, but in case of a lens, we get m equals to only v by u. So whatever the sign v and u that we discuss later, okay, that are the key points similar to the spherical mirror. But the normally the formula is m equals to v by u, but in case of a mirror, that is m equals to negative of v by u. This negative must, okay. So we can write from this to formula that m equals to h dash by h, that is equals to v by u. This is the magnification of spherical lenses. Either it will be concave or convex, for both cases it will be same. Now the key point is that for convex lens, u, convex and concave, similar to the mirror, because we draw the object or we place the object left side of the lens, similar to the mirror, u, that object distance for both lenses are negative. U is always negative. F, focal length. For convex lens, focal length is positive, but for concave lens, focal length is negative. Why? Because in case of a convex lens, we know that it is called converging lens. When it will be converged, that converge at the behind of the lens. That means in one side is object, the rays are incident on the lens. After lens, the another side, that means the right side, they will converge. So the focus point is behind the lens. That's why F is positive, it's towards the positive x-axis. But in case of a concave lens, the focus point is same side of the object, okay, because we use the dotted line, we consider it will be appear to a point on the principal axis, and from that point it will be diverged. That's why for concave lens, F is negative. So for convex lens and concave lens, U is negative for both lenses. But for convex lens, F is positive, and for concave lens, F is negative. Now V, because we already see that the ray diagrams in convex lens, only one position when it will be very close to the lens, only that condition the image is the virtual image. So convex lens has two possibilities, either the virtual image or the real image. Or if you see that, or if you remember that table, the five cases we get the real and inverted image, and one case we get the virtual and erect. But it's happening. In case of a convex lens, there's a two possibilities. Either we get the virtual image or the real image. So if the value of V is coming positive, that means it will be real image, because the real image is formed behind the lens. That means the right side of the lens. Okay, and for right side means positive x-axis, that's why the value is positive. So if V is positive, that means we can say that the image is formed at a certain distance from the lens, at the opposite side or the another side of the lens or the object, not the same side of the object. That's why it will be positive. And if we get the virtual image that you remember that diagram, the image is from the same side of the object. So it will be towards the negative x-axis. So that's why the V is negative for virtual image. For it is for convex lens, because two possibilities are there. So if the value of V comes in positive, it will be real image. And if value of V comes in negative, then it will be virtual image. But in case of a concave lens, we always get the virtual image. Not a single case we get the real and inverted image. That's why the concave lens, for a concave lens, the image distance, that is V, always negative. Always negative. Clear? Now the magnification. Magnification value, because m equals to h dash by h, or m equals to v by u. After putting these values, if the value of m come in negative, that is for real image. But if the value is come in positive, it's for virtual image. In case of a convex lens, because two possibilities that they are convex lens, either real image we get or the virtual image, that depends upon the value of v. So if the magnification comes in negative, that means it will be real image, and if the m come in positive, that means it will be virtual image. But in case of a concave lens, because we always get the virtual image, that means v is negative, so m always positive. Okay, so just once we recall that one, for convex lens u negative, v positive for real image, v negative for virtual image, f positive, focal length positive, m negative for real image, positive for virtual image. Concave lens, u negative, v negative, f negative, m positive. Just keep it in your mind, these things. Okay, and I will give this key points with the assignment 4. Okay, next topic of the lens, that is a new topic because it will not in a mirror, not present in a mirror. So this is the next topic, is the power of lens. I hope many of them are used as spectacles having different powers, because of the everybody has suffering the different diseases on eye disease, either metropia, hypermetropia or myopia, or both, combination of both hypermetropia and metropia. So we use for different power of lenses in our spectacles, and everybody not use the same spectacles, because it depends upon its eye damage, how much it will damage. Okay, that's why this is called power. So how we define this power in physics language? In lens, we know that lens are two types: converging lens and diverging lens, convex or concave. So it's what is its function? What are the function of convex and concave lens? Either it will be converge the rays of light or diverge the rays of light. So the ability to converge or diverge the rays of light, that depends upon the focal length of a spherical lens. It depends upon the focal length. Focal length, focus, at focus we get the clear image. So for focus to optical center, that is called focal length. So this ability, how much it will converge, all rays light converge, all light rays are diverge, or few are converge, how many are converge, the ability of converge or diverge a ray of light, that depends upon the focal length of the spherical lens, and it will be different for different human beings. And sometimes if the any disease are there, eye disease are there, then this focal length also be different. For normal eye, the normal distance is, normal near point is 25 centimeter. Within this distance, we can see the image of an object clearly. And the far point is infinity. This is for the normal eye. If any damaged eye means either the image is formed in front of the retina or behind the retina, that means it depends upon the focal length. Either it will be not converge, all rays of light are not converge. It depends upon the ability of the lens, how much it will strong. Okay, so this ability of converge and diverge rays of light depends upon the focal length, and this ability of converge and diverge of rays are inversely proportional to the focal length. That means if focal length is increases, then this ability of converge or diverge will be decreased. If the distance is more, normally you see that if you just think about this, if the distance is more, the focal length is a distance from optical center. If distance is increases, the ability, so the the rays of light travel more path to converge or diverge. So that's why the focal length the ability of the converge and diverge of the rays of light are inversely proportional to the focal length. If we increase the focal length, its ability decreases. If we decrease the focal length, its ability increases. So this means a lens with greater focal length has less converging or diverging ability of rays of light. For example, a convex lens of short focal length, that means it bends light rays to the large angle by focusing them closer to the optical center. Focal length is short, that means its ability to converge or diverge, it will be more. Focal length is short, so ability is more. So light rays travel a very small path and it will the image is formed very near to the lens, or it will be focused closer to the optical center. Similarly, a concave lens of very short focal length causes higher divergence. It is ability of convergence or divergence. If convergence is more, that means divergence also be more for a short focal length. So higher divergence than one of the one with the longer focal length. Okay, that means if focal length is short, the ability of divergence or the convergence will be more. So the definition is the degree of convergence or divergence of a lens depends on the focal length of a lens, and ability to convergence or divergence is called the power of the lens. How much it will power that everyone, every human being, we have two eyes. So inside the eyes, we know the structure of the eyes. Inside the eyes, one lens is there, that is convex lens. We have the convex lens. Okay. So this lens, power of this lens is different for different human beings. So the ability of convergence or divergence will be different for different human beings, and the focal length also be different for different human beings of that lens. Okay, that's why the ability of divergence or convergence, it is called the power of lens. It's called power of lens. When it will not happening, it will not properly converge or properly diverge, then that diseases that arises, either myopia or hypermetropia. Okay. So this is called power. Ability of divergence or convergence is called power of the lens. Okay. So the power of a lens is denoted by P. P is inversely proportional to the proportional to the focal length. So we can write P equals to 1 by F. So now here one thing you keep it in your mind, whenever we solve the numericals just 1 minute. SI unit of power is diopter. Is diopter 1 by F. F is a focal length. Focal length unit is meter. So we can write meter inverts. Power normally from that expression we get the SI unit of power is meter inverts. In one word it is called diopter or D. It is denoted by capital D. But one thing you keep it in your mind, we use this unit, that diopter, when the unit of the focal length is in meter. Unit of the focal length is in meter, otherwise we cannot use the diopter. So suppose if focal length is given in centimeter, first you converted it into meter, then you use the formula to find out the power. Otherwise you cannot write the diopter unit. If the focal length of the unit of the focal length is not in meter, then we cannot use this diopter unit. So if centimeter is there, first you convert it to meter, then you find out the power, then that will be the answer in diopter. That things you keep it in your mind. So one diopter equals to 1 meter inverse. That means one diopter is the power of a lens whose focal length is 1 meter. It is a definition of diopter. So diopter unit we use for power when the focal length of the lens is in meter. Now this power is for we have two lenses, convex lens as well as the concave lens, and we know that where we use the convex lens and convex lens hypermetropia and metmyopia, whatever. So for convex lens, the power of a convex lens is positive. The power of a convex lens is positive, but the power of a concave lens is negative, because for convex lens focus is positive. That key points, for convex lens focal length is positive, so power also be positive. But in case of a concave lens, focal length is negative, that's why the power is negative. Okay, now if the combination is there, one convex lens and concave lens, we use the signs positive and negative. Suppose one convex lens in contact with a concave lens having the power 2 diopter and 3 diopter, what will be the net power of that system? So for convex lens is 2 diopter, so that is +2, and for concave lens it will be 3 diopter, that means it -3, so 2 minus 3, that will be -1 d. So the net power is equal to the concave lens. So whatever the lens we use, that is a concave lens, its nature will be the concave lens. Clear? So whenever we solve the problem, we have to use this sign. For convex lens, the positive power is positive. For concave lens, power is negative. If a doctor prescribes us spectacles with power 1 plus 1 diopter, that means the lens is convex lens. So it will not mention over there. The power is mentioned +5, 0.5, +1 d. That means we use the convex lens. If the power is -2 diopter, that means the lens is concave lens. Clear? Now the net power means the instrument. Some instruments are there where we use the combination of convex and concave lens. We also discuss in a telescope, in these cases we use the 3 consecutive lenses, first convex lens, then concave lens, then again convex lens. So this is acts as a system. So total power is the sum of this 3 lenses. So how we can find out that net power? So the instruments like a high quality telescope consist of a number of lenses. So many lenses are combined to increase the magnification. Why we use the more lenses? Because we need to see the image of an object magnified and the clear image. That's why we use the combined lenses, either all convex lens, all concave lens, or mixture of convex and concave. That depends upon that situation. Sometimes we need the divergent lens. After divergence, we need it will be converse. So we use the convex lens. So this is a combination. Either it will be all convex lens. It will not happen that we use the all convex lens or concave lens. Maximum time it will be mixture of concave and 2 convex, 1 concave, 2 concave, 1 convex, like this way. So in that case, the power of that system is sum of the individual power of the lenses. That if in telescope 3 lenses are there, 2 concave and 2 convex, 1 concave. So that net power of the telescope, that will be, if we consider the for first convex lens, that will be power is P1, concave lens P2, and concave again convex lens, that will be P3. So net power of the telescope, that is sum of the individual power of the lenses P1, P2 and P3. So when we put the values over there, we use the sign, positive and negative sign. But this is a formula. Net power is equals to P equals to P1 plus P2 plus P3. If 4 lenses are there, then plus P4. But after that we understood, after that we see that the which one is a concave, we use the negative sign. Which one is a convex, we use the positive sign. When we put the values. Clear? Okay. So this is a formula for net power. P equals to P1 plus P2 plus P3. If n numbers are there, then up to n. Now the focal length of this combination, because we get P equals to 1 by F. So in place of P, we can write 1 by F. So because the net power of the system, so we consider the of that system focal length is capital F. So 1 by capital F, that is equals to 1 by F1, individual focal length of the individual lenses. 1 by f1, 1 by f2, 1 by f3. F1 is a focal length of first convex lens, f2 is a focal length of concave lens, f3 is a focal length of second convex lens. So here also, when we find out the focal length of the combination, that is 1 by f equals to 1 by f1 plus 1 by f2 plus 1 by f3, we use that equation, p equals to 1 by f. Clear? Okay, let's see some numericals, then you can understand easily. First numerical, a lens is formed by combining two thin lenses of powers plus 12D and minus 8D. Just first you clearly read it first. That means first plus 12D means convex lens, minus 8D means concave lens. So that combining lenses, two thin lenses, one is a convex, another one is a concave, okay, in contact with each other. What will be the focal length of the combination? So we use this formula, 1 by f equals to 1 by f1 plus 1 by f2. So how we can find out? So first of all, we find out the total power. So p1 equals to plus 12d, p2 equals to minus 8d. So p equals to, we know that because it is a combination, it is a system. So p1 plus p2, we put the values here, you see, we use the sign. For 12 minus 8, that is 4d. So the system is similar to the convex lens because it's coming positive, 4d plus 4d. So the focal length of the combination, f equals to 1 by p. We know that. So p already we find out, the 1 by 4, so that is 4. So 1 by 4, that is 0.25 meter. Always the unit of the focal length, from when you find out from power to focal length, it will be meter, not centimeter. Clear? Next numerical, an optician prescribes spectacles to a patient with a combination of convex lens of length 40 centimeter and a convex lens of 25 centimeter focal length. Okay, sorry, one mistake is there. Combination of a convex lens of focal length 40 centimeter. Okay, just you, when you write down this one, correct it, the correct the question. An optician prescribed spectacles to a patient with a combination of a convex lens of focal length 40 centimeter and a concave lens of 25 centimeter focal length. What will be the power of the spectacles? Okay, so we have two focal length, f1 equals to 40 centimeter, f2 equals to 25 centimeter. So we know that we use the adapter unit when the focal length is in meter. So first of all, we convert it to meter. So 40 centimeter to meter, 25 centimeter to meter. Then individually we find out the power, p1 and p2 for convex and concave also. p1 equals to 1 by f1, p2 equals to 1 by f2. But because the concave lens having negative focal length, that's why we use the negative sign. The concave lens having negative focal length. So that p2 will be in negative minus 4 and p1 is a convex lens. That's why it will come in positive 2.5D. So what will be the power of the spectacles? p1 plus p2, 2.5 minus 4, that is minus 1.5D. So what will be the nature of the system? It will be a concave lens of power minus 1.5. Concave lens of power 1.5, because concave we mention over there, concave means negative, convex means positive. Understood? Next, a convex lens has focal length 20 centimeter. So first of all, we convert it to meter and find its power. Normal, p equals to 1 by f, that is 5d. Plus 5d. When you write down the answer, please use the mention over there that convex lens is plus 5d. Okay. If you mention the sign also with you, then it's a not big deal. I think you mentioned the sign. For convex lens, positive sign you use. For concave lens, you negative sign you used. Next one. The combined power of two lenses. Okay, combined power is given, that is plus 10. So p equals to p1 plus p2, that is equals to 10 is given. When they are separated by a 20 centimeter, their power becomes 6.25d. when they are separated. So there will be another one formula, but it is not in your included in your syllabus, but still I think you have to know this formula. When the two lenses are separated by a distance, the power of the combined lens, that will be P equals to P1 plus P2 minus D into P1 into P2. This is a formula. Okay, you keep it in your mind, or this is not included in your syllabus, but I think that you have to remember for competitive exams. So P1 plus P2 minus D. D is the separation between the lenses, that P1 into P2. So we use this formula here. So when they are separated by 20 centimeters, so D is given, converted to meter, their power becomes 6.25. So P dash be the new power, that is P1 plus P2 minus D into P1 P2, that is equals to 6.25, because we use now it with a separation. So we use this formula. So P1 plus P2 minus D into P1 P2, that is equals to 6.25. And P1 plus P2 from equation 1, we get 10. So we put it over there. So we find out the value of P1 into P2. Now we use the mathematical formula A minus B whole square, that is equals to, we can write A plus B whole square minus 4AB. So here also we use same thing, because we need to find out individual power P1 and P2. So we have first equation P1 plus P2. If we find out the another one equation in terms of P1 minus P2, then easily we solve this two equation. That's why we use this formula. So P1 minus P2, that is equals to P1 plus P2 whole square minus 4 into P1 into P2. Now we put the values. So we get P1 minus P2 equals to 5. So in equation 1, that is P1 plus P2 equals to 10, and equation 3, P1 minus P2 equals to 5. If we solve these two equations, we get P1 equals to 7.5T and P2 equals to 2.5T. So this will be the power of the lenses. Understood? Okay. Next, a convex lens of power plus 4D and a concave lens of power 3D are here. Don't be confused. Concave is mentioned over there. That's why the negative sign is not used. Are placed in contact. What is the equivalent power of the combination? So P1 equals to 4D, P2 equals to minus 3D. We use the negative sign. So combination. P equals to V1 plus P2, we get the 1T. So equivalent power of the combination is 1T. This all about the power. But we already studied the lens formula, but we did not solve any problem based on the lens formula. So let's see the first problem. I also got this formula problem from the website. So in assignment 4, you get the assignment from number 2, because one we already we solved. That's why the in assignment 4 starting is question number 2. Question number 1 I will solve here. So that starting number is question number 2, 3 up to 15. I think up to 15. So don't be confused. It will be started from question number 2, because question number 1 I will solve here. That assignment I will get from the website. So first numerical, a 4 centimeter tall object is placed perpendicular to the principal axis of a convex lens of focal length 20 centimeter. Okay. So 4 centimeter tall, that means h is given, height of the object 4 centimeter. Focal length is given, this is a convex lens, so focal length is positive 20 centimeter, and u is given. If the distance of the object is u is already for both lenses u is negative, that is minus 30 centimeter. What we find out? We find out the position, nature, and size of the image. Also, we find out the magnification. Okay. So first of all, we find out the v, because we need the position. So one use the lens formula, 1 by f equals to 1 by v minus 1 by u. So after putting the values, we get v equals to 60 centimeter. So v's values come in positive. That means V values come in positive. Yes, so that means it will be real image. Sorry, I will confused between the lens and the mirror. That's right. sorry. So image position is 60 centimeter from lens, other side of the object or behind the lens. And we know that for convex lens, the V is positive for real image. So the nature of the image is real. We did not mention here the inverted. Whenever the image is real, it's always inverted. Inverted means below the principal axis. So first we find out the height of the image. If it will come in negative, that means it will be inverted. So just now we have this information that image is formed at a distance of 60 centimeter towards the behind the lens or other side of the object, and it will be real. So we use the magnification formula, m equals to h dash by h, that is equals to v by u. So we find out the h dash, we know the value of h, v and u. So h dash equals to, we get minus 8 centimeter, we get minus, that means it will be inverted image and it form below the principal axis. So the image position is behind the lens or another side of the object, other side of the object at a distance of 60 centimeter from the lens, and the nature is real and inverted, and magnification m equals to minus 2. Minus means because real image, in real image we get the magnification is negative, so magnification is negative means here it is denoted that it will be real image. And magnification is 2. You see that the height of the image is 8 and height of the object is 4. So it will be twice of the object. The height of the image is twice of the height of the object. 4 into 2, that is 8. Clear? Okay. Next, NCRT exercise question number 10. If you have that book, so in question number 10, h is given 5 centimeter, u is given minus 25 centimeter is given, but convex lens and concave lens u is negative, and f is 10 centimeter. The problem is related to convex lens. So we use the lens formula. What we find out? We find out the image distance and the height of the image, and we also draw the ray diagram. So first of all, we use the lens formula, put the values over there, we get the V equals to 16.66 centimeter. That means it will be real and inverted, real image, not the inverted, we cannot see the inverted. Okay, real image, and it is formed at a distance of 16.66 centimeter or 67 centimeter. At a distance of 16.67 centimeter from lens, and behind from lens, other side of the lens, object or behind the lens. Okay, I see this diagram at a distance of 16.6 centimeter. Now, if we use the formula of magnification, we find out the h dash. So we know the value of h, u and v, put it over there, so we get in minus. So h dash value is minus, that means the image is inverted image. So real, inverted, and size is 3.3, and the object height is 5 centimeter. That means it is a smaller than the object. It is smaller than the object. So this is the diagram. When we get the smaller and real, inverted and smaller than the object, two cases are there in case of a convex lens. When the object is at infinity, we get the image at focus, but it will be point size, smaller, but it will be small point size. But here you get one value of the height of the image, that is 3.3. So the second position, when the object is placed beyond the 2F, then the image is formed in between F and F2 and 2F2, the another side of the lens, and it will be smaller than the object. So this is the ray diagram. When the object is placed beyond the 2F1, so image is formed in between F2 and 2F2, and the size of the image is smaller than the object. Distance already we measured. Clear? 11 number is focal length is given. Focal length is negative. This is for the concave lens. Here also we draw the ray diagram. So F is minus 15, V is given. So from the length formula, we find out the object distance. It will be minus 30 centimeter. So the negative value of U indicates the object is placed 30 centimeter in front of the lens. Negative side means right side, negative x axis, in front of the lens. So that this is the diagram. The height is AB is the 30 centimeter is the object. And V is minus 10 centimeter. That means the image also from the same side of the lens. That A dash B dash is the image. And this is the ray diagram for this problem. Question number 12 is related to mirror. So that is U equals to minus 10 centimeter or F equals to 15 centimeter. Use the mirror formula. You find out the V. And we also find out the magnification minus V by U. We get the 0.6. So image is located at a distance of 6 centimeter from the mirror on the other side of the mirror or behind the mirror. It will be virtual image, erect, and size is 0.6. That is very, very smaller than the object. So that's why it will write diminished. And magnification come in positive. So in case of a mirror, when the magnification is positive, that is a virtual and erect image. Okay. And the other numerical you try to in your home, if you have any problem about that problem in your NCRT, please write in a comment box that in NCRT exercise this problem you have doubt. So I will solve that one and I will post or I will upload another video of that doubt cases. Okay. So whatever the assignment you get, the assignment question number started from question 2. One number already I will solve here, that's why it will start it from 2. Don't be confused, and I will give that key points when you take negative, positive with that assignment. Okay, so if you have any problem regarding the power of a lens or this all about this magnification lens formula, please write in a comment box. Have a nice day. Take care. Bye bye.